What I want to do in this video is think about why it's so hard for a monopolistic competitor to make money in the long run. And just as a reminder, monopolistic competitor, it's much closer to perfect competition than it is to a monopoly. What it means is that you have a monopoly on your differentiated product, but eventually other people are going to make substitute products. They can't make exactly your product. It can't be identical, and it might eat into your demand. And to understand that, let us draw the demand curve for a market in which monopolistic competition is going on. I'll draw it nice and big. And so on this axis right over here, I'm going to plot dollars per unit. And so price is revenue per unit, and we'll have cost per unit and things like that. And in this axis, I'm going to have quantity produced in a given period of time. And we're going to speak in fairly general terms over here. Now, let's assume that our monopolistic competitor right over here is Apple and its iPads. Apple iPads. And I want to emphasize, I'm not making any accusations that Apple is a monopolist here. They just have a differentiated product, and so they are monopolistic competitors here. They have a monopoly in iPads. They don't have a monopoly in tablet computers or in computers in general, but only they can sell iPads. And so let's draw the demand curve in the short run for iPads, and I'll make it linear to make things simple. Let me draw a little bit better than that. So let's say the demand curve looks something like that. So that is our demand curve. And we know that if that's the demand curve, and remember, we're talking about the market for iPads, not the market for tablet computers. Apple is a monopolist in the market for iPads, so its marginal revenue will have twice the slope of this demand curve. So it will look something like that. That is Apple's marginal revenue curve. And then think about its short run economic profits in a given period of time, whatever this quantity per period of time is. Let's draw its costs. So first I'll draw, let me draw its marginal costs. So its marginal costs might look something like this. That is their marginal costs. And then to do average total costs, up here, when you have very low quantity, most of your costs are fixed costs, but you're dividing it by a very small quantity. So you're going to have a very high average total cost. It's going to get lower and lower and lower as long as the cost on each incremental unit is lower than the average. And the cost on each incremental unit is a marginal cost curve. So as long as the average total cost is higher than the marginal cost curve, then that's going to be downward sloping. And at some point, they're going to be equal to each other. And now each incremental unit that you add on is going to increase the average, because each incremental unit's cost is more than the average. So it's going to cause everything to average. It's going to cause everything to average up. And this actually right over here should be the minimum point on our average total cost curve. So given the way I've drawn things, what is Apple's short-run economic profit? Well, we just have to think about its optimal quantity to produce. So it's definitely going to produce one. The marginal revenue, much higher than the marginal cost, is going to make economic profit on that unit. It's going to keep producing, because that continues to be true all the way into this point right over here. And it doesn't want to produce more than that, because then the cost, the opportunity cost on each incremental unit is higher than the revenue on that. So you're going to take an economic loss. So you're going to produce right over there. And at that quantity, so I'll call that Q star right over there. At that quantity, this is the price that they can charge in the market going into the demand curve. I just went straight up to the demand curve over there. This is the price that they can charge in the market. And their average, or you could view that as their average revenue per unit. And then we have our average cost per unit right over here, an average total cost. So this is their average economic profit per unit. And if we multiply that times the total number of units, if we multiply times the total number of units, the area of this rectangle right over here is going to give total economic profit. Total economic profit. Now, in all things, if the rest of the world sees economic profit, they're just like, wow, that's a good, you know, people are doing better in that market than their opportunity costs. And so the other competitors say, well, I can't produce iPads, but I can start making competitive products. So you'll see players like Samsung, and we are seeing this sitting here in 2012, and this is kind of a work in progress for these competitors right over here. Samsung, HTC, HP, all the tablet manufacturers, all the computer manufacturers, and they're pairing up with the operating system manufacturers like Microsoft and Google's Android, and they are making competitive products. And on top of it, they are marketing it. They're marketing it heavily. They're trying to market the products as aggressively as possible. And so as their products become more and more comparable to an iPad, or maybe even better in certain dimensions, either cost or features, and they market it heavily, in the long run, what's going to happen to Apple's demand curve? Well, at any given price, less will be demanded, and so the demand curve will shift. The demand curve will shift to the left. And so we could end up with a new demand curve, I'll do it in a different shade of blue, that looks something like that. So this is our new demand curve, or we should say maybe our long run demand curve after these people have made their products better and have marketed heavily. If that's the new long run demand curve, then our long run marginal revenue curve was going to have twice the slope of that. So it's going to look something like this. So if it's twice the slope, it's going to hit the line, it's going to go hit right about, it's going to look, I can do a better job than that. So our new marginal revenue, let me do it in a slightly different color, I'll do it in pink. Our new marginal revenue curve will look something like that. So this is long run marginal revenue curve. And so now what is the optimal quantity for Apple to produce? Well, now it's going to make economic profit all the way until this point right over here. So now we have this new, I'll call it long run quantity. Or maybe I'll call it, let me do it in a different color. I'm using that pink too much. Long run quantity right over there. And to figure out the revenue per unit or the price and that at that quantity, we just go up to the demand curve, our new demand curve. Remember, our long run demand curve, it's right over there. It looks like, at least the way I've drawn it, that the price hasn't changed much. We've got the same price. But now what is our average economic profit per unit? Well, the way I've drawn it, the average total costs right over there are right about what that price is. So our average economic profit per unit goes down to zero. There is, over here we had this nice green height, now we have no height anymore. And even though we're selling a good number of units, our average economic profit per unit is zero. So instead of an area over there, we're going to have the area of a line, which is essentially zero. So now we have zero economic profit. So the important thing to realize for a monopolistic competitor, and this won't happen overnight. I mean, some would argue that sitting here in early 2012, Apple is still generating economic profit. And it's always important to realize economic profit is different than accounting profit. Accounting profit can be positive. Economic profit can be zero when accounting profit is positive. So if you're running, you could even have an economic loss and still have accounting profit. But some people would argue that right now Apple is still making profits above and beyond even their opportunity costs. And this is actually a work in progress right now in 2012, that the demand curve is shifting to the left, but eventually all of the economic profit will be eaten up and there will be less incentive for all of these players to be as aggressive. So the important thing to realize with the monopolistic competitor is, sure, their curves look like a monopolist, but the competition doesn't happen in terms of supply of iPads. None of these players can supply iPads. The competitive part happens with all of these people producing substitutes and being aggressive about it and eating into the monopolistic competitor's demand.